Well, Mr. Tuttle, it's a great project wrapped up.
Wonderful. Your team did an amazing job recapturing the history here.
Oh, thank you, sir. It was our pleasure to restore this place to its former glory. To be honest, it's just amazing that the Blackgate Manor's been vacant for all this time.
Zoning laws, bureaucracy. Getting permits to restore even an unofficial landmark like this wasn't cheap. Not to mention the restoration costs themselves.
Still, in the end, it was well worth it.
Just imagine the stories these walls could tell.
Well, Mr. Tuttle, the contractors will send their final invoice at the end of the week. Thank you again for purchasing our services.
Oh, of course, thank you.
Now you show up? I called hours ago. I can't stand it. I can't stand the noises, the scratching on the walls. I've had it. I can't take it anymore.
Just be cool. It's all good. Scotty's here to help. My last appointment ran a little longer than usual, but believe me, it was worth it.
Is that lipstick?
So, where exactly is the problem? I gotta wrap this up pretty quick. I'm supposed to be somewhere else.
The attic.
Good. That's great. I was hoping it'd be in a ridiculously small space.
Is this going to take long? I'm meeting the bridge club.
Ma'am, look. Okay. Just let me do my thing here, okay? I'm about to do battle.
But I'm meeting the bridge club.
It'll take as long as it takes.
But...
Okay, just, you know what? It's all right. Just relax. Go watch some soaps. I hear that The Old and the Hopeless is on. This week, they're supposed to find out why Catherine's kids won't call anymore.
So much for calling Pest off and for signing up for our safe extermination goal plan. I believe this is yours. If you'll fill out a short survey online on our website, would be greatly appreciated. Have a nice day.
Of course, Dr. Jameson. No, the dissertation is well on its way. Wait, what? Why would I have to change the topic?
Well, I know I said experimental lasers, but I'm not talking theoretical lasers. The applied orbital science. Which one's my favorite? Why, the Empire Strikes Back, of course. I mean, I know it's cliche and a lot of people will choose that one. Hello? Hello?
Excuse me,
Yeah, what can I do for you?
Well, I was hoping you could help me, Professor...
Kozowski. Gavin Kozowski.
Sorry. Sarah Cole.
Yes! I've watched all of your broadcasts on the student network.
That's funny. I didn't think anyone actually watched those.
Oh, I watch everything you do.
Huh. Well, good. Hopefully I'll be doing the real thing someday. Well, Professor Kozowski, I was hoping you could direct me to Dr. Hudson's psychology class.
Psychology? Now there's a fascinating subject. I mean, all of those hormones and emotions and glands. It's a far cry from journalism, though.
Well, I try to stay well-rounded.
Yeah.
Easier to conduct interviews if you can read their minds, right? For instance, what are you thinking of, Professor?
Hudson! Dr. Hudson's class meets here, through the foyer, down the hall, on the left.
Okay, then. I'll just...
Scott, I thought I told you to check the mail. Scott, did you get paid yet? You really gotta start taking care of these. Scott, I know you're faking. You only snore when I talk about money. Fine. I guess I'll just throw away this half a box of pizza then.
No, you won't. I'm still eating that.
Of course. It hasn't changed color yet. How could I forget?
That's right.
And what are you still doing here? Shouldn't you be at work?
It's churro time, Gav. There was no work during churro time. You know this.
It's 4:15, Scott.
I know. What are you doing here? Shouldn't you be wandering the park, muttering equations to yourself, Professor?
Don't call me that.
Well, I mean, come on, look at you. You're still two semesters away from that PhD, but I'm pretty sure Bill Nye's looking for the guy who ripped off his wardrobe.
Do not talk smack about the science guy. He is dope and you know it.
Dope. Yes, that's the word I was looking for. Besides, I forgot how much the ladies hang all over those PBS types.
Oh, I forgot how they hang all over guys who say, the ladies. I'm having an identity crisis here, man. I met this cute girl after class and she was... scrumptious.
Oh, please tell me you didn't say that out loud.
No.
Okay, put her on the scale.
I would say somewhere between Meg Ryan in the 80s and my ex.
You found your ex on Tinder, Gav.
It doesn't matter where I found her, Scott. She was hot, okay?
You used the word glands again, didn't you? I told you that subliminal stuff doesn't work.
Oh, like it didn't get you to stop leaving your dirty underwear on the floor?
Oh my god. Okay, that wasn't clever, that was passive aggressive, okay? And I only stopped because I felt sorry for you. So, proceed, lady friend.
I blew it. She mistook me for a professor and I was too nervous to correct her.
Oh my god, Kozowski, you're gonna have an aneurysm if you don't learn how to lighten up. I mean, please tell me you said something mildly interesting. Dude, you gotta get out of those books for one night.
I have goals, Scott. Do you think I want to end up like you, taking 3-hour lunch breaks and eating 4-day-old pizza? And look at you. Have you even bathed today?
That's fair. That's fair. But you know what? I happen to like what I do for a living, okay? I provide this community with a very valuable service. I'm protecting the populace.
Are you seriously comparing rodent extermination to crime fighting? That's reaching, bro.
Listen, all I'm saying is that I'm worried about you, bro. Okay? That's it. You need to get out there and do something spontaneous. Ditch the frickin' tweed and the elbow pads. Come on, son. Really? I mean, hook up with this girl, okay? Go on a safari. Manscape. Gavin, do something edgy.
You know, I have been thinking about starting a book club.
No. That's wrong. You're really missing the point.
Scott, we've been friends since what? Thundercats?
Ho!
So you know that things have to start changing around here. If I don't get my PhD soon and start paying off this vortex of student loans, I'm gonna lose everything. And if you wanna stay here, you need to start using your money for bills and not trips to Hooters.
Okay, say one more word about that fine establishment and you are dead to me.
This is Kozowski's Palace of Passion. How may the love doctor serve you?
Mr. Kozowski?
Bill Collector of Star Wars Fan Club.
Look, Mr. Kozowski, a member of my staff, Dave Jennings, has been involved.
Dave Jennings?
Look, he hasn't been injured, but he's had a breakdown of some sort. We don't have any emergency contact information for him, but I found your business card in his wallet, so I'm assuming you know him. Something strange has happened, and we can't get him to talk to us. Can you come down here to the Blackgate Manor Hotel? Perhaps if you can get through to him, we won't have to call the paramedics.
Okay, yeah, man, let me put on some pants. Swanky if you're Norman Bates.
I'm still not talking to you. I can't believe you answered my phone.
As me. Oh, get over yourself, princess. You could use a little intrigue in your life.
You don't think this is a little weird? I haven't spoken to Dave in like 5 semesters.
And while the rest of the sexually active world would have chosen the word years, our hero stands firm in his social awkwardness. And besides, we shared a dorm with the guy like 10 semesters ago, so show some love.
Sometimes I have to remind myself you even went to college.
Me too. Where is this guy? He said second floor, right?
I don't know. You talk to him.
Actually, you talk to him. Yahoo!
Mr. Kozowski?
What? Oh, that's Professor Kozowski, actually. And this is my lovely associate, Mr. Bo Jangles. Fastest growing hip-hop polka fusion artist in the country.
Wonderful. Listen, your friend, he collapsed in the bathroom upstairs. This way.
I've never been escorted to a bathroom before.
You've been escorted out of one.
Not wrong.
The sheer level of vandalism. It's just horrible. We just remodeled. Your friend's been huddled in the fetal position in there for hours. Won't say a thing.
What happened?
I haven't the faintest idea.
Looks like Johnny Depp stayed here.
Dave? Dave Jennings? It's Kozowski. Can he hear me?
What a wreck. Must have been one hell of a bender, eh, Dave?
He didn't do this, Scott. You wouldn't do this, would you, Dave? Those eyes, like fire. I gotta get them out of my head.
Yep, bad tequila will definitely do that.
Dave, don't you recognize us? It's Gavin Kozowski and Scott Bixby. We shared a dorm back at school.
You think he still remembers school?
Come on, Dave, we gotta get you out of here. Where are you living now?
He's coming for you. The darkness. Those eyes will burn into you, consume you.
Oh, yeah, he's tripping, man. Now might be a good time to...
A ghost! An evil spirit in this place, bringing death! I am a Voria!
Oops. Good hands, man. Good hands.
I think he needs a doctor. I mean a medical doctor.
Sir, I went ahead and called the paramedics. They're on their way.
Oh, well, I'm sure they will have the situation well in hand. Do you have a moist towelette? Oh, or one of those pillow mints?
Yes.
Check with reception on your way out.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Alfred. It's been a blast. Gotta bounce.
I'm sorry, people don't say that.
Did you see his face? He didn't just say he saw a ghost. It looked like he saw a ghost.
And time.
What?
Bro, I knew you wouldn't even make it back to the apartment before you started geeking out on the whole ghost thing.
I'm just saying, you gotta keep an open mind when it comes to this unexplained stuff.
You know, I saw one once. Straight up. Mixed the wrong two pesticides in an enclosed space. Of course, there were unicorns too, though, so.
Oh, ha ha. Laugh it up, Bix. You realize that there are chances that there are undocumented energies that could affect the environment like that. It's only supernatural as long as you can't explain it.
Okay, I'm deleting all of your Ghost Adventures episodes off Netflix.
No. Yeah. And while we're at it, where were you when he was on top of me? He had me like this.
I had your back, bro.
From across the room.
You know what's right around the corner, right?
Yes.
Yeah. I smell it. Yeah. I'm down. Are you down?
Oh, I'm always down. Funnel cake! We coming, baby.
Hi, do you guys need anything else?
He'll take your number, actually.
Scott! Excuse me, miss. He's off his meds. Hey, man. Take a break, okay? You don't have to be a giant douche all the time. And what are you working on over there? You've hardly touched the funnel cake since we got here. Scott!
What? Hostile? Professor.
You haven't been this quiet since I've met you. What has you so captivated over there?
Research.
Research? What, did Hooters announce a new calendar or something?
Okay, who told you you were funny? All right, so you say that this whole ghost thing is legit, right? I think you're nuts. Totally certifiable, all right? But apparently you're not alone because there are over 40 locations reported haunted just here in the city.
So, what?
So that led me to look up this company that got started in New York back in the 80s. And since then they franchised small businesses across the country. But this area, nada. What are you getting that PhD in again? Context clues? A business, dummy. Let's start a business. I mean, there's plenty of work, apparently, and we would corner the market here. These guys make total bank. We could have all of your student loans and your entire pleated pant collection paid off in no time.
Doing what, Steve Jobs? I'm not gonna quit school to follow another stupid scheme of yours, all right?
Dude, you're the one that's into all of these ghost hunting shows where they run around in the dark and breathe hard in the camera.
I enjoy the shows, Scott. That doesn't mean I'm gonna drop everything I'm barely juggling now to start a business with you. First of all, I love you, bro, and you know it, but you're not exactly business partner material. And secondarily, you don't believe in this stuff.
Okay, that hurts, Gav. Yeah. From a guy who's had many, many jobs with several different businesses. And you know what? I don't believe in that stuff, okay? But that doesn't stop crazy people from paying for the services.
Scruples, bro.
Stop making it worse to make yourself sound smarter, okay? This is a hands-on gig. You can use your dormant brain power, and with my experience in extermination, it'll be a snap. Look, we buy into a franchise, okay? They send out a specialist to train us. All you gotta do is take out another student loan, you know, and we will officially be, okay, paranormal investigators and eliminators. Sexy, sexy.
No. Oh, and did I say no? I'm up to my eyeballs in debt already, Scott. This is just the latest in a long line of stupid ideas you come up with to make cash that somehow always end up in this thick fog of debt around me. Besides, where's the return? This has nothing to do with my PhD program.
Are you kidding me right now? Don't pretend like you're not geeking out over this idea. You'll actually be practicing physics.
Practicing physics? Scott, you practice physics every time you cross the street, anytime you stand up, open a door, anytime you find your body in motion, you're practicing physics.
And they give out a degree for that?
Seriously.
You know what? I'm gonna save you. From yourself, Kozowski.
Who are you gonna call?
How about Destiny, Kozowski? I'm calling Destiny. Don't you get it? This is our opportunity, man, to become something more than just two roomies in their 30s scraping for takeout.
Become what, Bix?
Ghost buggers. Bastards? Busters. Ghostbusters.
We need a business plan. You have not done market research.
We're doing this, Gavin.
We need to hire an accountant. Talk to a lawyer.
We're doing this, Gavin.
We need a car.
Do we need a car? Where are we gonna get a car?
Thank you, Michael. This is Tiffany Ferris coming to you live from St. Francis Medical Center. The attack happened late last night, sometime after midnight, as an employee of the newly restored Blackgate Manor was walking to her vehicle. As doctors work to learn to understand the mysterious coma she is suffering, the police have not ruled out the possibility of foul play. Back to you, Michael.
Creepy, huh?
What, studying?
That's two freaky incidents involving Blackgate Manor in the last 48 hours, and we were just there yesterday. Don't pretend like you're not the least bit curious.
I have a paper due tomorrow, Scott. Please spare me the sales pitch.
Okay, fine. The charms! She made all the charms, man!
It had to be done. They were beckoning me in the nighttime.
No, take your Lucky Charms issues elsewhere.
You are researching Blackgate, you friggin' sneaky bastard.
So I'm mildly curious.
Were you gonna start a business? I knew you couldn't hold your nerdy bladder for long.
Stop with the flailing, Ginger. I don't want anything falling out of that robe of yours. And I haven't agreed to anything yet.
But there's a yet. You said the word yet. Okay. How long have you been looking at this stuff?
Since the story first aired this morning.
Well, don't hold back. What'd you find?
Apparently, this Dr. Oswald Crane built a manor in 1800. He later converted it into a hospital to deal with a bunch of consumption patients.
Ah, alcoholics, huh?
Tuberculosis, Scott. Apparently, it's been reconverted into a hotel this year. Nothing really special about the place, except in December 1886, the good doctor suddenly vanished.
What?
It's very weird, right? And this was during the same period where there was a string of serial murders all over the area.
God, I would love to dig into the history of this place. Okay, all right, come on. Don't play. We're doing this, right? Tell me we're doing this.
I'm never going to see the light of a debt-free day, am I?
Jasdowski, we are going to make so much money. All right, that's it. Don't make me disrobe.
No, God, please, no.
It's happening.
No! Let's do this.
Oh, come on, we are gonna start business. Gonna do a business and make some money. Money, money. Money.
It's between a liquor store and a mortuary.
It's perfect!
I see. This is petty cash well spent. Sniper, top left.
Oh, thank you.
Nice.
It's used. I got a good deal. And by the way, I quit Pest Off today, so we're kind of on a timeline now.
Scott, we don't even have our equipment yet. You're killing me here. Tell me you at least gave them 2 weeks.
I gave them 2 texts.
Could you at least pretend to be a responsible adult here?
I'm an adult. Besides, I needed the time to launch our marketing campaign.
What?
Strange voices, feelings of dread, unmentionable things in the nighttime.
Sounds like you have a serious ghost problem, and I'm just the man you need to beat them off. We're the Ghostbusters. We have the tools to exercise those creeps and ghouls that keep you up at night, haunt your dreams, and freak you out of your pants. So pick up that cell today and ask for Scott Bixby or my associate, Dr. Gavin Kozowski, because we are ready to believe you.
Ghostbusters! Bustin' makes us feel good.
Huh? Huh?
Where was I during all this? Is that the best picture you could find?
You were studying or starching your socks, one of those. And okay, it was either that picture or the
fine, whatever.
Hello, Dr. Kozowski.
Dr. Kozowski? How can I help you?
I'm at the Regional Ghostbusters office. I'm here to meet with Dr. Kozowski. I'm here to certify your Ghostbuster franchise.
That's right. That's me. Gavin Kozowski, pleasure to meet you.
Dr. Park, too formal for you, huh?
Well, no, I don't actually have my PhD quite yet, so I...
No PhD. Yeah, our regulations require at least one PhD on the team in a qualifying field for you to have a franchise license, so sorry, I wasted your time.
Scott!
Sorry about that. Have a nice day.
Yeah, I must apologize for my colleague. He's quite modest.
Apparently.
Right this way, sir.
What? Why would you tell him to have a PhD?
It's your PhD.
That's enough to lie. You lied to him.
All right. It's been a very long drive, fellas, from the regional office. And I gotta tell you, if you don't have a PhD in-house, it's been a big waste of time.
See, I think I can clear this up. My friend here actually is...
Just a couple of semesters away from my PhD!
So, I take it to mean that you guys did a fraudulent franchise application. Which at least is better than the one you did in Gold Sharpie, Mr. Bixby.
Scott's heart is in the right place, but we have to come to some sort of arrangement here. I mean, I have invested a lot of money in this, and you've invested your time.
Yeah, right. All right, I have to be back at the regional office in a few days. If you can show me your current transcripts, I'm gonna give you the allotted 72 hours of training time. And then I'm gone.
But we have tasty snacks.
Look, I'll discuss your situation with my colleague when she finishes taking care of your accommodations. And if she's willing to stay in town on a supervisory role. Let me warn you though, if she doesn't endorse your franchise, I'm afraid you fellas have wasted not only a lot of money and time, but we're talking $300,000 fine, confiscation of all your equipment, cease and desist order, and a hazmat cleanup bill for the firehouse.
So you're saying we have a chance.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Well, in the meantime, make yourselves familiar with this and these.
Okay, that's not too bad.
Will be a test on them tomorrow. Oh, and by the way, you're going to be using our equipment. And that's at least until you can procure and design your own. I take it you have an in-house engineer?
Sure. Well, you got this, right?
You wanted to see me, Cap?
Jesse, you may want to sit down.
Captain, if this is about that homicide on 6, I've got it covered. I even just finished interviewing that Jennings guy about the coma attacks.
The homicide is being pulled from your desk. Carter's taking the lead.
What? Carter? He was just transferred in and he's taking the lead? But I've already run the scene with forensics.
Jessica, you're technically not homicide yet. And I really need you focused on these word attacks. I've got women dropping like flies all over that area. And the comas are odd, to say the least.
That's bullshit, Cap. I'm one recommendation away. Yours, in fact. Look, I can handle my caseload. Why don't you give the attacks to Carter?
I know you can handle it, Lasky, but this case is getting more and more press, and I've got city officials turning up the heat. I need it wrapped and fast.
And you don't think I can multitask? I've already conducted interviews on both. I even have the attending physicians running toxicology for narcotics.
What did I just say? I know you can handle it, Jesse. But you're one of my best investigators, and I don't want your attention split on this one. Carter may be new to the precinct, but he's not a rookie. He can handle it till you get this figured out. This is not a woman thing.
Of course it's not, Cap. It's a political thing. Gotta keep the mayor and his goons happy. Why are you kissing their asses on this?
If you were anyone else, I'd throw you out of this office. I don't have to explain a damn thing to you, Detective. I want this thing put to bed. I want it over. So I suggest you make an about-face and march the hell out of here right now.
Fine. But I want your recommendation after this.
Setting terms to your superiors now? Tread lightly, Sergeant.
If that's how you want to see it, I want that open desk in homicide. I deserve it. I've earned it. And you know it, sir.
I take it you fellas are caught up in all the required literature?
Sure. Did you happen to have any of that in the pop-up variety?
We're up to speed, sir.
Good to hear that. All right, today we're going to introduce you to all the tools of the trade.
Great. Will there be time for recess? Well, hello. I am,
In my way.
Dear Jesus. Seed break you.
All right. I cannot stress enough. Safety is paramount importance when using this equipment. This is a nuclear accelerator, after all. It could do more damage you could hope to pay for, ever.
Well, that's not saying much right now.
Well, speaking of, I was reading that there is a company insurance policy.
They keep their hands pretty full. It's better to not even file a claim.
Makes sense. Right, Scott?
Your client's liability waiver usually will cover you in most cases.
We have some facility maintenance scheduled. I'll hang my GED there. You'll never notice. So when do we get introduced to...
When I decide whether or not you're worth knowing.
Oh, I like her.
Look, fellas, let me explain something to you. Our job is to franchise legitimate businesses and get them off their feet. I've worked too long and too hard to let Ghost Corps go down just because some inadequate frauds can't handle their equipment.
See, the thing is my equipment is 100% under control.
Is it, Scott? Is it really? Because let me just paint a picture for you. After Dr. Jenks leaves for training, and if I decide to stick around and endorse your franchise, that means your equipment and your ass belong to me. So keep me happy, Scott. Okay? Because if you don't, I promise that you're gonna look like that smoldering hole in the wall over there. And after I kill you, I'm gonna bust your ass just for the fun of it. Okay, handsome.
What the hell are you wearing?
It's from the Magnum PI collection.
Well, it looks terrible. Give it to me. Today, since you decided to embarrass us and wear this out in public, give me 20. I meant 20 push-ups, but I'll take that. Since you let him go out like that, I want 20 from you too. 20, both of you.
Why'd you let me dress like this, Kevin?
Gibbons, I told you, it looks
left. It's part of the freaking Magnum PI collection, okay?
Such a
baby.
I don't want it. Come on, boys, pick it up.
This is stupid. Why do I have to do this?
Because you were a jerk to him and pulled out the ladder.
It was funny.
It's not funny.
This is stupid.
This is funny. Keep going. 4. 5. You need to make sure you're paying attention to what this is doing when you're reading the room. If you pick something up, these will actually open up and they'll move. Right. You can too. You can look too by the lights. You can see how much it's. You can see. Let him go. There's no way. There's no way. You can't do that. Oh.
Ho! That's good. That's good. That's good. That's good. Dude. Yeah.
I'm proud of you. What is up with you two throwing up?
I did that. I don't think they like us.
Ah, come on, Gav. Don't be so hard on yourself. You know, they do say that second impressions are actually the most important.
Scott, you of all people need to be schmoozing your way into their good graces. We're one screw up away from blowing this.
Really? A guy shoots one little hole in the wall and everybody's panties come unraveled. And you just use the word schmoozing. What's wrong with you?
It's not about the wall, Scott. You were staring at Jasmine, Dr. Griffin, the whole time. Not cool.
Ah, Jazz. What a great name. You think she's a Miles Davis fan? So I bet we could really dig on some Miles.
I'm just hoping Dr. Jenks lets her stay long enough to be an observer and get us our endorsement. And that's if she wants to stay.
Would you relax? We've got the tools, we've got the talent. All we need is business, man. Okay? That's it. Besides, the charm that I'm laying down on Dr. Hot and Scary guarantees that she's gonna stick around until you get your PhD and we get our endorsement.
Charm. That's an interesting synonym for harassment.
Ghostbusters, your possession is our obsession. Really? Wow. Okay. Well, how much you got? We'll discuss your financial obligation, ma'am, once we have the opportunity to evaluate your situation. So, can I get your address real quick? Mm-hmm. Yeah. Excellent. Thank you very much.
Are you alone right now?
Yes, ma'am. We are on our way. Thank you.
What are you doing? We have one more day of training and we're supposed to schedule these a week out.
Listen, we have bills, okay? I'm getting us a paycheck. Are you down for this or not? Yeah, Gavin, come on. Woo! Yes,
yeah.
Except
what?
It's the other way.
This place is definitely haunted.
I think I saw it on the Munsters once or twice.
I'm being serious.
You're always serious. Let's just make a paycheck, Gavin, okay? Hi, Scott Bixby. This is Dr. Gavin Kozowski. We're the Ghostbusters.
Sorry for calling so late. I just didn't know what else to do. We just moved in here a couple weeks ago, and we haven't slept hardly at all.
Understandable. We?
My husband and I.
Damn. Scott. Gavin has a few questions, ma'am, regarding our service agreement. But first, I'd like to inquire as to how you found out about us.
The TV commercial that's been playing the last couple of days?
Ma'am, would you mind describing exactly what's going on?
Ever since we moved in, there have been strange noises coming from the kitchen. My husband thought it was the plumbing, because it's an old house. But then things started moving around, and I started to feel like I was being watched. And then the touching started.
Touching?
It was like, well, I'd be touched and nothing was there.
That's fascinating, ma'am. Gavin, isn't that fascinating? Yeah. Where exactly?
When I'm getting dressed, in the shower, when I'm...
No, I mean where?
I thought I was going crazy until tonight. Then I saw it.
Saw it? What exactly did you see?
I got a glimpse of it out of the corner of my eye. I was getting dressed, and it sort of hovered across the room and was covered in a thick, I don't know, smoke. And then I couldn't help but notice the smell.
Smell?
Well, it was... I'm not sure I want to say. It's kind of embarrassing.
Oh, don't be afraid. We haven't even begun to embarrass ourselves yet.
Well, it was a bittersweet, kind of skunky...
Oh, I know exactly what you're talking about.
Oh, you do you? You know what she's talking about.
Yeah. Remember that semester where I read the article about how cannabis helps mental focus and I had that big test to study for?
You didn't. Kozowski, did it help you focus?
I don't want to talk about it. Moving on. Does this happen a lot?
This is what I'm talking about. It happens 2 to 3 times a week.
Okay. Actually, if you'll follow me right this way, ma'am, I've got a liability release and waiver for you to fill out. It just, covers us for any potential damages. Nervous in the service there, Gav?
Funny. Did you get her taken care of?
You know, not quite how I'd imagine. But good thing is she's gonna be out with the hubby for the next couple of hours, so we got the place to ourselves.
Oh, nice TV.
LED? Huh?
She did say it was coming from the kitchen.
Good. You go check it out. I'll investigate the bedroom.
No, I'm not gonna be spook bait while you go panty raid that poor woman's dressers.
Really, that's creepy. People don't really do that.
Oh, that's not why you snuck away to the girls' cabin at Camp Tanakawan in the 8th grade?
Oh, how would you know? You chickened out and wouldn't go.
That's because I knew you were gonna get caught.
You didn't know that.
Did you get caught?
That's not really relevant, but did you narc on me?
No.
Bro, you know
why would I narc on you? I have nothing to give
you. Your nostrils are flaring.
You made that happen to me. I'm lying, and it's not.
Narc.
I thought she said she was gone.
I did. She is. No! Me, it's all her. I've been doing everything.
Gavin, I missed it.
We gotta get a reading. The PKE is registering a Class 6 ectoplasmic entity, and we know it has kinetic abilities.
Man, I'm dizzy. Is it dizzy in here?
No, Scott, focus.
I'm focused. Bro, I am so focused.
Hey, there's that smell she was talking about. I think our smoky specter has been getting ghoulish with the ganja. That's pretty good. What the hell are you doing?
I'm chomping Cheetos. The hell are you doing?
These aren't yours. Seen molecular readings like this. There was nothing like this in the field manuals. I think we found something that they've never seen before.
Cool.
Yeah, cool. Look, why don't you go clean up and get the slime off before it takes more effect, okay?
Happy slime!
Well, dude, I'm gonna get a line on this thing while you avoid falling over or passing out, all right?
I'm trying to catch a ghost. But there's a ghost inside of me. Am I trying to catch myself? Who am I gonna call? Wow. That was unexpected. Okay, Smokey. I'm coming for you.
Where'd it go? Feeling better?
Yeah, lots. Good to be back.
Yeah.
really hope that wasn't anyone important.
Viking burial for me. Just.
Kevin!
Woo! I got him! I got the little panty raider! Woo-hoo-hoo!
Great, I'll set up the trap.
What? What's that? I don't hear you laughing now. Does it tickle? Does it tickle?
Trap deployed.
Quick, get a picture.
What do we need a picture for?
Get a Facebook page.
You're on track. Just keep that stream on him.
We need a sample of that ectoplasm.
Scott? No.
Oh, yes.
No!
Yes, ma'am.
No, I completely agree.
Yes. Oh, no, I understand. It's a scorching and all that, yes. Yes, I do understand how that could be misconstrued sexually. As an innuendo. Yeah.
Uh-huh.
You too. Yes, he will apologize, yes. Customer service, very, very important to us. We like to repeat business. Anyway, yes, thank you. Bye. Yeah, that was fun.
Client kept me on the phone for 2 hours, guys. I suppose you think this is a big success.
She called for service.
Scott? Remember that conversation we just had about keeping me happy?
You're already not happy?
You ruined that woman's kitchen.
It was totally an accident.
You fried her grandmother's ashes.
In all fairness, Granny can't burn twice.
About the only thing you two did right was you got the client to fill out the liability waiver before you vaporized your kitchen. She doesn't even want to know what's all over her nightgown.
One lawsuit, that's all it takes, boys. I mean, we have a great legal team, but technically you guys aren't even official yet.
Vaporized the kitchen, slimed a nightgown, burned Granny's ashes. Back in 91, when I backed my first ghost, I accidentally vaporized the interspatial viewer Egon was working on. It's not an official endorsement, but if Jazz here will stay on as a supervisory role, welcome to the Ghostbusters.
What? Oh, we did it. We did it.
Yeah!
That really hurt.
Yeah, good luck.
Ah, yeah.
Why aren't you wearing pants?
They're part of the coveralls.
It's a long story.
You're supposed to put...
It's a covered Nash.
I know. What are you going to do?
Lasky, go.
Jesse, tell me you've got something.
Yeah, I'm working on it, Captain. I'm tracking a lead right now.
Please tell me it's something solid. If I have to listen to the chief one more time over
the... Don't worry about it, Captain. I'm on it. There's a group of guys that keep popping up all over this, and I'm about to pay him a visit right now, okay?
Okay, Lasky. Find me something.
You guys aren't even a legitimate franchise.
No.
Fellas! Glad you Denver boys could make the trip down. We got some feisty ones for you today.
Yeah, nothing like driving all the way down from Denver to help out a fraudulent franchise to operate.
Oh, friendly fire. You missed coffee this morning, didn't you?
No, actually, that's his happy face. I missed the coffee.
That's unfortunate. You know, if corporate would just install a containment unit here, then you guys wouldn't have to make that long trip down. Maybe you could put in a good word for us?
Really?
That's my... Thank you. You know what? Here, just take this.
You got a little in your, yeah.
Suit up. Looks like we get to do this guy's job for him.
You still want us to put in the good word for you?
Yeah, I mean, after you've had your coffee, that'd be nice. Thanks, guys!
I've answered doors.
Well, hello. How can I accommodate you today, miss?
Detective Jessica Lasky. I need to speak with you and whomever else interviewed Dave Jennings 3 weeks ago.
Okay. You wouldn't happen to be enforcing any unpaid parking violations or anything, right?
Wasn't the plan, but I'm flexible.
I'll bet you are. Jennings, Dave, yeah, the guy with the thing. Right this way, Detective, and I'll show you all my other tricks for getting arrested.
So you have a bachelor's in engineering.
Oh yeah. Yeah, I can make anything you want, from a microwave to a nuclear missile if you wanted to. I mean,
nice.
You want one?
I mean, not that we would need a nuclear device.
Of course not.
I mean,
yeah,
there's no national security.
I mean, where are you going to find uranium?
Located in this location.
Really that,
yeah,
anyway.
But
yeah.
Never would anyway. Yeah. It's
a subtle.
Scott, you know what? I was just thinking that it would be great if you could take over the second half of the interview for me.
No,
we're a team, and I mean, seriously, if you don't...
Actually, I am going to leave you in the very capable and moisturized hands of my associate, Dr. Gavin Kazowski, while I finish up here.
This way, is it?
Can I get you anything? A cup of coffee?
Oh, no, thank you. I've already finished mine.
Okay, what can I do for you, Detective?
Nice place you guys have here. You're just getting it up and running, I take it.
Yeah, we have been really busy this week.
Good. I've been reading a lot about you guys in the paper, in the police reports.
Really?
Yeah, strangely enough, there are paths seem to be crossing a lot lately. I'm investigating a series of strange attacks downtown, and
Blackgate!
That's right, Dr. Kazowski.
Actually, it's not a, call me Gavin.
Gavin. Jessica. Anyway, I'm investigating the series of strange attacks, and it appears that you're conducting interviews with everyone that I'm conducting interviews with.
Well, we do try to be thorough.
I'm gonna need you to stop that.
What?
David Jennings, Linus Tuttle, the Blackgate staff. I'm gonna need you to stay away from my witnesses. Frankly, I'm not even really sure where your interest lies in all of this.
Dave, I mean, we go way back.
Oh, and it's merely a coincidence that your new business is listed under private investigation?
Ha! No, see, that's just our latest attempt to broaden our market. You do understand what we do here, right?
I have a vague idea. You con superstitious people out of their hard-earned cash.
No, that's actually not correct. What we do here is we wait for our clients to give us a call, and we investigate paranormal activity, and subsequently investigate, address, and, if possible, eliminate the problem.
Ghostbusting. You managed to keep the doors open doing that, Gavin?
You'd be surprised, Jessica.
Oh, I already am. Here's the deal, handsome. I'm a real police investigator, and this is my case. In my experience, other people poking around have a tendency to create some serious disruptions. They scare off witnesses, tip off suspects, they make a real mess that I have to clean up and make sense out of.
Listen, Detective Lasky, I...
Oh, don't let a little police reprimand ruin the first name thing we got going on here, Gavin.
Okay, Jessica, I assure you, our interest in this is purely scientific. Think of us like the X-Files. I mean, our focus is exclusively on the paranormal, whereas we are more than content to leave the bad guys to you guys.
X-Files, huh? You're really into this stuff, aren't you?
I'd be pretty bad at my job if I wasn't.
All right, Mulder, I'll tell you what. You stay away from my witnesses and I won't have to escort you down to the station for obstruction. I'd really hate to arrest a nice guy like you, Gavin.
Hey, look, I wouldn't mind an interrogation or an interview, if you think it would help.
So, I mean, you can build stuff, right?
He likes it, doesn't he?
Yeah. In fact, he may need a little supervision.
What information could you possibly have for me?
Well, I'm assuming you've already had the hospital run the usual narcotics checks in a case like this, and I'm assuming they don't have a lot of theories involving these mysterious comas.
Yes, I have, and yeah, it's been difficult to explain.
Well, I am also assuming that the doctors haven't found any physiological evidence that would give them cause for something like this, right?
Your theories are starting to sound a lot like facts, Gavin. I'm listening.
Well, would it be considered bribing an officer to, say, take you out for coffee in exchange for a viable theory?
I might make an exception for a legitimate theory.
Wait, really? I mean, yeah, and do I have a theory for you? When can I pick you up?
All right, hotshot. 7 p.m. Thursday night, and I'll pick you up, okay?
Roger that, or 10-4, whatever detectives say.
Oh, and from one X-Files fan to another, try to keep your theory in the realm of believability. I'm not much for ghost stories.
Oh, she likes the X-Files! Were you listening?
Bro, I'm your wingman.
Yeah, but what about the interview?
I have to say that the takeoff was phenomenal, but sadly, the landing...
Don't listen to him. You did great, player, all right? Oh, and Mr. Martin
Alex.
Here? Alex can build all of that sciencey crap we need, too, so...
Cheddar!
Great, that's great. Alex, when can you start?
Actually, when exactly is Small, Dark, and Gorgeous inspecting our gear?
What are you talking about? Jenks already let us borrow the gear way longer than he promised. It's going back to corporate on Wednesday.
So today! How's about that, Sparky? Want a job? You can start today, sir.
I'm Sparky.
You got a job. Oh.
Hotel wouldn't run out of hot water.
Well, it is an old place. See what I'm talking about?
Thank you.
Honey? Honey? Baby? What the hell? Honey! Come on. Wake up! Somebody help!
Good evening. This is Warren Pez coming to you live from downtown. We're at the newly remodeled Blackgate Manor Hotel just over my shoulder. Another unexplained coma victim has been found. Fear is rampant, dare I say epidemic. Police are very tight-lipped as to the cause of this, but my sources tell me, Warren Pez, that it may be an airborne illness that we're dealing with.
Wait, it seems we have a new development here. Yes, a new paranormal investigation agency, the Ghostbusters, are arriving right now. There they are, right over my shoulder. Maybe there's more to this story than meets the eye. Here in the thick of it, as usual, I'm Warren Pez.
Nah.
What are you all doing here?
Detective. Jessica. There's obviously a really good explanation for all of this.
Wow. She's really cute. She's never gonna go out with you.
Shut up, baby. Gavin, I'm surprised to see you here after our little chat.
Right. Well, you see, what happened is we got a call.
Whoa. So, here's the skinny of your lawfulness. The thing is that we received a call from the victim's husband who specifically requested the Ghostbusters to be here. And according to the online certification that we have for private investigators, we're actually allowed to loiter here.
Oh, are you sure about that, Mr.?
Come on. Scott Bixby. This is not hard. The irresistible ginger, devilishly handsome, you're killing me here.
Okay, Scott. I appreciate that you're trying to take the heat for your buddy here. And according to the law, I am bound to allow you the privilege. However, let me make myself explicitly clear. You are walking a very tightrope here. The millisecond that your presence interferes with my investigation, I'll come after all of you, this whole Scooby gang, including you and your charming friend here, and haul your asses down to county to a full cell with one toilet.
Challenge accepted.
What? Challenge accepted?
Yeah, I accept the challenge.
It's not a challenge to accept. She's threatening to throw us in jail. She's saying, tread lightly.
How do you expect me to tell the difference? She dropped it like a challenge. It sounded like a challenge, so I accept.
Pay attention.
She's asking us to tread lightly, and so we're going to tread lightly. So the lady asks, so the lady shall receive.
Good. Now you'll all tell me if you find anything relevant to my investigation. Got it, boys?
Absolutely. And we're still on for Thursday, right? 7 p.m.?
Thursday. Oh my God, you're a virgin. Sorry, you're a virgin, aren't you?
That's uncalled for. She's a police officer. What am I supposed to do right here? Unleash the panther on her?
The panther?
That's the
panther.
Really?
Yes, and the panther still has a date despite all of your best efforts to piss her off. So I would say that's score one for the panther.
I think that's our guy.
Excuse me, sir. Are you the gentleman that called us? We're the Ghostbusters.
We're here to help.
The police just left. The paramedics took my wife already. I would have went with her, but I just couldn't move.
Looks like you're still in shock. You might want to get yourself checked out.
I'm fine. Look, I called you guys because the police think I'm nuts. But I know what I saw.
Easy, Chief. What exactly are we talking about here?
Tall, glowing, it just hovered above the ground.
Look, I know this is difficult, okay? My associates are gonna go check out the room for you. We're gonna get your statement in the meantime. Yeah, we got this.
We do?
God, I hope so.
Yes. No. Right this way, sir.
Definitely dealing with the poltergeist. Level 7 or higher. These readings are disturbing.
Really? How bad is it?
Somewhere in between Teletubbies and Scott leaving his boxers in my desk drawer, some subliminal message.
I can only hope that someday he uses his powers for good.
There's PKE spikes everywhere. It's almost like this entire building is some psychokinetic hub.
Dr. Griffin?
Whoa, are you telling me that this is all connected?
Of course, I mean, look.
Don't overindulge him too much, Alex. He lives for this crap.
Look at the pattern of the attacks. Each of these women have shown up in a mysterious comatose state, and each of them within a stone's throw of Blackgate, and that's not even the half of it.
That's not even the half of it?
Don't say I didn't warn you.
I had a hunch about this a couple days ago. That's why when you guys were out getting chalupas, I went and visited the victims in the hospital. These women demonstrated a total lack of spiritual reading. I tried everything, PKE, electrospectrograph, everything. They're just not there.
I dated a few women like that.
What she's saying is these women are devoid of any life force that we define. It's like their bodies are alive and functioning, but they're just shells.
I've dated a few women like that.
So somebody with a real panache for soul sucking is running amok downtown?
Exactly. Whoa. Day two here. What does this all mean?
So that can't be a residual haunting then. I mean, there's gotta be some kind of intelligence orchestrating this, right?
No, that's exactly right. And the guy last night said his wife was stabbed, but there are no physical injuries. And that the spirit seemed to glow brighter with each attack.
Of course, it's not just attacking them. It's literally draining their life force to gain strength. And for the stabbing routines, many entities at this level are bound to their previous life experiences, and they project those experiences into the present.
Huh.
I'll dig up what I can about the history of that place and see what I can find.
Actually, I might have beat you to that one, Gorgeous. So, you were telling me about this weird doctor that built the place back in the 1880s, right? Well, some really crazy stuff happening back then, too.
He can retain information.
Yeah, jokes, yeah, funny. So, Dr. Oswald Crane builds the place and then in 1886 mysteriously vanishes after a long string of crazy, brutal serial killings. Check this out.
Wow.
I know, right? Baskin. History Channel, bro. I studied, okay? We're talking about the 1880s, right?
Get to your destination, Scott.
Well, let's take a look at the period. This is not the only weird series of killing sprees that's taking place, okay? Like, the very first serial killer, right here in the US, a guy named H.H. Holmes builds a murder house in Chicago. Super creepy. But then only a few years later, in Whitechapel, London, we have everybody's favorite homicidal maniac, Jack the Ripper. Yes. So we've got very similar MOs, and Jack was never found. So, kind of remind you of anybody?
Oswald Crane.
And the ginger gets a cookie.
Not bad, Scott. Hate to admit this, but I think you're onto something.
You contributed.
See, the trick is to wait until the last possible minute.
I'll get on it. Scott, since you, strangely enough, have a handle on the history of that place, why don't you take Blackgate Manor, see what you can find out about Dr. Crane.
On it.
Emmy?
Well, if this entity is getting stronger, I'm gonna need you to install some updates to our equipment.
Okay.
And I'm gonna have Jenks send us some of the Spangler specs.
Great. Alex, I'll give you a hand.
Yay!
So, I'm eager to hear your theory, Gavin.
All business already. Can't be good.
Gavin, you seem like a genuinely nice guy. I don't typically conduct interviews like this, but I do have a job to do. Look, Gavin, I'll come clean with you, okay? I don't pick up witnesses when I'm off duty and have dinner with them. You're a handsome guy, and I think you're sincere, but I'm a cop, and my priority has to be this case. Now, I'm trying to find out what's happening to all these women, and you and your crew just keep popping up for some reason. Now, I agreed to this because I am interested in you, but I can't let that interfere with what I have to do.
Do you ever put your interests before your career?
That's probably why I'm still single, Gavin. It's not a career, it's who I am. But
Anyway, I just wanted you to know that I didn't agree to dinner lightly, okay?
Are you sure it wasn't because of my manly physique?
Oh, look, it's,
come on.
Really? Scott! Would you excuse me, please?
Hey, I had a... One sec. Really? Great. Come on, Rip.
Another escort to the bathroom.
What are you doing here?
Okay, they have half-price Frappuccinos on Sundays. It's called Holy Frap.
It's Thursday.
Is there a point in there somewhere?
If you screw this date up,
I'm not gonna sabotage your date, buddy, okay? I'm here for moral support. That, and I need to bum the company car from you because we're gonna get fried chicken later.
Look, I know this is all a big joke to you, but I really like her, okay?
Okay. Okay, bro. You got this, all right? Team Gav.
Yeah,
team Gav. Yes, let's do it. Hey, hey, psst. Unleash the pimp.
Sorry about that.
So, do you have any new leads?
I'm right back to interrogation mode. I should have seen that coming.
Look, I'm just trying to put this case to bed. I don't have time to wait for some judge to sign a stupid piece of paper while some poor girl could be lying on the pavement right now. That same judge could put you and your friends away for obstruction and interference.
There is no playing nice with you, is there?
That's it. I'm not playing, Gavin. This is who I am, and real people are getting hurt.
Well, that's why we're doing this, to stop people from being hurt.
By charging them for a light show and a pseudoscience demonstration?
A pseudoscience? Here, let me ask you this. Have you ever been scared?
I don't have time
for
this.
No, just answer the question. Have you ever been scared?
It's part of my job that I deal with every day.
Bullshit. I'm not talking about walking into a room full of gangbangers with Kevlar on your chest and a gun at your hip. I'm not talking about the scared you feel when you're facing something you can't explain. I'm talking about real fear. When you're looking at something you know you can't explain. When your instincts bail on you because you have no idea how to deal with the horror staring back at you. There's no training, no manual, no procedure to help you with this. And the fact that no one else believes you makes it that much more terrifying. That's real. Now look. If you're a good cop, and I think you are, I know you've seen the look I'm talking about. You interviewed Dave Jennings and the guy whose wife was attacked. I know you saw that look in their faces.
It's irrelevant.
The hell it is. What did they say? Come on, what did they say? I know you think we're full of it, but we hadn't even met the guy in the hotel before you talked to him. What did he say?
They said it was a ghost. They both did.
They did. We didn't. Now, come on, detective. Follow your leads, right? If you have multiple witnesses telling you the same story, then you know there's got to be some shred of truth in there somewhere, right?
Look, I want to believe you. I do, okay? But let's just say for a second that I believe all of this pseudoscience crap. Then you tell me, what the hell is going on here?
So we already have chicken money now.
Chicken money!
Chicken money!
Chicken money!
Chicken money!
Chicken!
Yeah. Also finished those upgrades on the pack. I think you guys are gonna like what I did.
Yeah?
But, can we roast tasty marshmallows?
Good idea.
Right?
Uh-huh. So, Black, any progress on that?
Yeah. Nothing good, though. This Dr. Crane guy really, really creeps me out. I mean, interest in the occult, really reclusive, and then he just vanishes, disappears from the face of the earth. Textbook weirdo.
But nothing connecting him to the killings.
I mean, nothing definitive, but I'm pretty sure he's the guy. In fact, you know what? You're an engineer, so you can probably appreciate this.
Yeah?
I'm looking through these old documents, right? And I come across some old labor contracts. And apparently, Crane hired a crew to come to Blackgate and build something there, but there's no updated blueprints for it. You can't find them anywhere. Anywhere. I mean, I looked the archives up and down, and you can't find it. And then, I mean, there's obviously no additions to the manor that anyone can see, so what did he build there? And where the hell is it?
So the crew must have been paid to keep quiet.
That's what I'm thinking. A lot of shrouded history in that place.
So you think this all connects to Blackgate?
Well, that's what the evidence suggests.
I'm not saying I believe any of it, but I do see some interesting coincidences here.
That's all I'm trying to say. Something about the history of this place that's just dark. It's like all of this has happened before. What? What did I say?
I can't believe I'm about to tell you this. My family might be involved in that history.
What? How so?
The Laskys have called the city home for generations. My great-great-grandfather, John Lasky, he was a surgeon's assistant back at Blackgate when it was a tuberculosis hospital. He was hanged for the 1886 murders.
Are you serious?
See this? It belonged to my great-great-grandmother, Marion. He gave it to her as a wedding present. It's been passed down through the women of my family for generations.
Wow, I don't know what to say. It's
a miracle that my family was able to hang on to it, considering what happened to them. Not only was she murdered, I know he was innocent. And I'm not just saying, I can't tell you how many times I've researched old documents, old police reports. It never made any sense. He loved her dearly, and their son grew up an orphan over this whole thing. Part of me always wanted to remove the blemish from my family name, you know? Sad, really, this locket serves as a reminder of justice never really served. Sometimes when I look at it, I can't help but feel angry, unsettled.
I understand. I see why you're so dedicated to your job.
Oh, I can't tell you how many times I had to kick vandals out of Hangman Park back when I was in uniform. It used to really get under my skin.
What?
Hangman Park? There's a whole urban legend surrounding the tree they hung my grandfather from. Not so cool and exciting when it's a member of your family.
Wait.
This is stupid. It's probably not even the same tree out there.
And they named a city park after that? That's twisted.
It's just what the kids call it.
You know, what do you say we put this urban legend of yours to rest, huh?
What? What are you talking about?
Well, it's not like I'm interrupting a date. Let's go out there. I can take some readings and maybe make a believer out of you.
I don't think that's a good idea.
Oh, come on, detective, what do you got to lose? If I'm wrong, it proves I'm a fraud, but if I'm right, maybe it proves that I'm more than just a handsome con man.
All right, let's go. You know, most guys would be trying to buck me up for coffee right about now, not lurking through the darkness hunting for spooks.
Well, then, I would say it's a good thing this isn't actually a date, and maybe, just maybe, you'll have enough time to prove to you that I'm not a lunatic.
Gavin, I know I can seem cold, but I don't want you to think
no,
that this is...
No, please. Don't do that. I don't want your pity. I know I'm a catch.
There. There it is. That's it. That's your tree then.
Well, nothing unusual so far. I say we can call your urban legend debunked.
You sure you're using that little gizmo correctly, Doctor?
Well, Detective, now you're interfering with my investigation. Hold that thought.
Kazowski?
John? John Lasky, what do you want?
Justice! I want justice! He took her from me. Fattest of evils. Brings out the purest of evils. From here, across the sea. I'm a warrior. Brings death. Death is coming.
That sucks.
It must be stopped. The evil must be stopped. There must be justice. Mary. Justice.
What the hell was that?
That would have been your great-great-grandfather. Cured your skepticism yet?
I don't know how you did this, but I'm not. Did you put something in my drink?
What? Did you just see that with your own eyes and you still don't believe me?
Oh, I'm a believer, all right. I believe you orchestrated this entire thing, you son of a bitch!
Oh.
Stay the hell away from me, and stay the hell away from my investigation, or so help me God, I will find a reason to use excessive force.
Jessica! She was my ride.
No.
Nah.
Have you ever been kicked in the nuts?
Repeatedly.
What took you guys so long?
Scott crashed Gavin's date for money. And it was crazy.
What?
We have a problem.
How did you get here? An Uber or something?
I just had a conversation with a level 7 Vapor's apparition.
Seeing here, I was worried about you showing the lady a good time.
We're on to something here, guys. Paranormal activity is off the charts, and after what happened to me tonight... Well, it turns out our detective friend, she's the descendant of the guy who was hanged for the 1886 murders.
That's the guy I was telling you about. John Lasky. He was Crane's personal assistant.
Maybe she's a trigger object?
Well, now that's a little insensitive.
No, stupid. Maybe she could be a catalyst for this whole thing, a descendant of the victim's bloodline in proximity of the manor.
So this is your girlfriend's fault, then?
Girlfriend. It didn't exactly go well, Alex.
Oh.
What did the spirit say?
Whoa. No social cues there, Jazz? Read the room, okay?
He just kept shouting about justice and how Amavoria was growing in power. Whatever that means.
Wait a second. Amavoria. Isn't that what Dave said when we were at the hotel?
Yes.
It sounds like a name. He said he was taking the victims to become invincible?
Oswald Crane. It's the ghost of Oswald Crane.
Amavoria is Latin for bloodlust. Tobin's references an ancient evil that's said to be the right hand of death itself.
Well, good.
Is this a bad time to ask for a raise?
That's not it. I found the global connection that we're looking for. Rumors of a cult called the Dark Brotherhood that emerged in the 1870s with disciples on both sides of the Atlantic.
Fratres Tenebris.
What did you just say?
Fratres Tenebris. The Fraternity of Darkness. Dark Brotherhood. John Lasky said that before he dematerialized.
OK, Okay, if their motive was to gain power through these murder rituals, maybe they're sacrificing the victims to the same Avoria.
Or worse. What if Amavoria is more than an idea? What if they're actually sacrificing these people to manifest an entity? Amavoria, summon the right hand of death.
Hey, scratch the whole raise thing. Can I just have a severance instead?
No.
If I'm right about this, I don't want to see what happens when this thing reaches full strength.
We may need to look into boosting pack output if this thing manifests into a single entity.
I don't know how many times I can upgrade these stars. Okay, but without blowing up a city block, at least, but I have worked on a stasis stream, though. Yeah, it's able to capture people in case they get possessed or dangerous or angry about their bill.
Yes, I love that.
What about the s'more? There was a s'more attachment,
hey,
and you can put a marshmallow.
Guys, if the spirit accumulates enough energy, it may not even matter.
Well then, what a novel idea I've just had. Why don't we go down there and bust this freaking thing and bill an unreasonable amount in the process?
Yeah. It's not gonna be that easy, guys. Jessica is furious about this, and if we keep crossing paths with the Popo, we're all ending up in jail.
I'm not a fan of the incarceration thing. I'm wanted in 3 states.
Come on, guys. You're killing me here. I mean, I bet you if we save the city, they won't care so much. I mean, what are you afraid of? Handcuffs? I bet you're not.
What?
Look. All I'm saying is that let's take in the entire situation here. What's worse, going to jail or the end of the world?
I'm not saying we do nothing. I'm saying we need to be strategic about this. I can't go to jail, Scott. I have soft skin and it bruises easily.
Moisturize hands.
You do. Well, I suppose I can increase the output of the throwers, but it's gonna take all night and...
Okay, let's not get ahead of ourselves. Let me just talk to HQ, see if they can talk to the police. And then maybe we can get some cooperation.
That's great. That's, you know what? While you guys are busy wading through that mountain of red tape, I'm gonna be getting ready to save the world. Okay? Right after I polish off that bag of marshmallows.
I've seen that look before. Talk to me, Jesse.
I don't have anything to say, Cap.
That's a first. This case is really getting you, huh?
I can handle it.
Without question, but that's beside the point.
Look, Captain, can this wait? I've got a lot of work to do.
Damn it, Lasky, I'm trying to talk to you here. Stop for just a second and listen. You're a good cop, Jess. You care about your work and you get results, but you shut out everyone around you. That's why I've never assigned you a partner. Part of being a good cop means trusting the people you work with.
I trust.
No, you don't. And don't try to sell me that you do. We have a tough job, and every one of us has to become hard inside to stomach it. We're lied to every day, and have to proceed on imperfect information. But Jessica, if you don't pick someone to trust, that hard gut is going to eat you up until there's nothing left.
It keeps me alive.
It keeps you from living.
What are you doing here?
We need to talk.
Do we? Because I think you made a great point with that last right hook.
Look, I maybe...
Overreacty. Owe me an apology? Uber fare. Sure.
So, you gonna invite me in?
Do I have to let you in? I mean, I guess you haven't flashed your badge or called for backup yet. I could close the door and you could kick it in if that would help.
Look, I know the way things ended last night, and I...
Assault? And abandonment?
I get it. You have every right to be mad, Gavin. But can't you see this from my perspective for just 1 second? I don't believe in... ghosts. I've spent my entire life in pursuit of facts and hard evidence.
Well, I'd say the evidence is pretty compelling, wouldn't you?
I don't do that, you know? I
I don't take chances on people because in my experience, it always ends up in disappointment.
And in my experience, if you trust no one, then your life ends up a disappointment.
Turning my words around into a clever little cliche. Well, I'll tell you what. You don't think I know what fear is, Kazowski? I'll tell you what fear is. Fear is opening up. It's allowing yourself to be vulnerable. It's letting someone in, because while they're in there, they can do a lot of damage. My shield isn't just a badge. It's my protection. If I let you in, what will you do with my heart and your hands? I've seen more ugliness in this world than you can ever possibly imagine. And what if just a fraction of that seeps in? Do you know what fear is, Gavin? Fear is not being able to do your job because the world has cut you too deep. It's putting your trust in someone and watching while they take advantage of you. It's finding yourself paralyzed because that someone has ripped the heart from your chest and left you alone. I know what fear is, Gavin. And to me, it looks like you.
I don't know who did that to you, but I am not that person. I'm just a guy who believes in something. I've seen the ugly too, and like you, I've decided to put on a uniform every day and try and fight it. I'm on your side, Jessica. We are on the same side.
I guess we agree on the crazy part.
Please, give me the opportunity to prove you wrong.
Okay, look, I just want to make it clear. All of this was Gavin's idea.
She's not here to arrest anyone, Scott.
Well, then I take it all back. I will now turn it over to Dr. Snazzy Yoga Pants for the halftime update.
How have you not hit him yet?
Because that would be child abuse. And I already have. All right, guys, so the findings that we got at Blackgate Manor classified Dr. Crane's ghost as a class 4 anchored phantasm. Right, with kinetic ability.
But an anchored spirit would be bound to the manor, so if that's the case, then how were these women attacked away from the hotel?
Right, the range of the attack spans a full 5 miles.
Yeah, and a class 4 entity couldn't leave the property. I mean, unless it found some way to somehow possess a living host.
So, we're looking for a person.
Right. Now you're talking some sense. I've canvassed the entire area multiple times. I've interviewed the owners, the staff, the guests, even some of the vendors, but none of them really produced any substantial leads. I mean, none of them have any motive.
So we know the why, but now we need the who.
Yeah, we do. Dude, she's even got good taste in music.
Can you really be that stupid?
Is he okay?
He does that.
Assuming we might have the motive, who at the hotel would have both means and opportunity?
The whole staff, really. But if I'm trusting my instincts, I gotta say the owner.
Alfred!
Linus Tuttle.
He's given me the creep since the very beginning.
Uh-huh, we'll go. Is your eyes? Yes. Yeah.
All right, let me handle this, okay? I'll go down, drop in, pay him another visit.
Dispatch 512.
512, dispatch.
How come you don't have one of those jets?
Captain Davidson is trying to reach you. Please contact him on his cell ASAP.
10-4.
What's going on?
I'm not sure. I need to make a call. Please, keep me in the loop here, Gavin.
We sure will.
I'm sure. Guys, we gotta have cool code names. I will be the Ginger Ninja.
That's a terrible idea. I'm gonna call you Marshmallow Fluff.
Officer, I need you to establish a perimeter.
Everybody keep back. Everybody stay back. Stay back in the building.
What in hell is this?
You tell me, Lasky. We got a call when the hotel staff couldn't get in the building. Then when the light show started, people started to panic. This is your scene, Detective. What's going on here?
Gavin was right.
Can I just say again that this is a really bad idea?
Don't be a soggy man with Alex.
I haven't really had a chance to finish the throwers. I mean, they just were finished a few hours ago, and I haven't even tested them.
Sparky, how long have you been working for us now?
Yeah, we don't exactly test things here.
Not listening to this.
Where am I going, Gav?
Her message was really garbled, but I heard her say something about, I'm going in. Maybe she's grabbing Tuttle?
Alone? That is not a good idea.
Yeah, that's why we're on the way.
No, you don't get it. Crane only needs one more victim to gain full manifestation. And if he gains full manifestation, then he doesn't need a living host to lead Blackgate. There's no limit to the damage that he could do. And not to mention, your girlfriend is the last living descendant that's attached to the manor.
Oh my god. It's a trap. Blackgate, Scott, step on it!
Very strong signal here, fellas. This is like nothing we've ever seen before.
Careful, guys.
You must be the exterminators Lasky's been telling me about.
Yes, sir. Where is she?
She went inside. I don't even know how. No one else has been in there since this started.
We're gonna do everything we can.
Get in there. Take care of it.
Hey, we'll get her out of there, okay, bro?
So I guess we're going in.
Not everybody. Alex, I need you to hang back. See if you can get in touch with Dr. Jinx, because I have a feeling we're going to need backup on this.
Hey, I'm not opposed to, you know, not going into the paranormal hellhole of death over there, but...
If
you guys get in trouble.
Well, then you'll still be around to stop the apocalypse. Okay, Pumpkin?
You don't have to do this. I couldn't ask anyone to do this with me.
You kidding? You're my brother, Gav. You're not doing this alone.
If you girls are done cuddling, can we go destroy the evil entity that's destroying the city right now?
No love for the romance.
I heard that.
Jessica!
Three to check in. Yep, I think we might be at the wrong evil haunted hotel.
No. This is the right one. But that doesn't mean this is the Black Gate we know.
Well, that's because we crossed over into some interdimensional membrane. All that PKE energy is creating an overlap between our world and something else.
Well, I don't know about you guys, but I'm disappointed in the service.
Just set your thrower to stasis. Tuttle is human after all. I think we should split up, cover more ground.
Good idea! How do you feel about that, Scoob?
Ruh-roh.
Yeah. Kid, I'm gonna make you famous. Health Inspector!
Get out!
There you are!
Scott, you idiot!
What?
I was blasted!
arrested, you guys!
I just rescued you.
Mm-hmm. Oh, my hero.
Oh. Thank you? You're welcome? Nothing?
We need to finish this fast.
I'm not leaving without Jessica.
We won't. But we, listen, we gotta stay together, okay? And we gotta pin Tuttle down somehow.
Boys, we've definitely crossed the spectral plane. It's merging with Blackgate.
Agreed. So how do we get out of here?
We don't, unless we find her and stop the ritual.
That's exactly what we're gonna do, but where would they be holding this ritual?
In a room. That's what Crane was building. He was building a room.
Oh, I swear to God, if you don't add more details,
right? Just trust me, okay? We are looking for a hidden room. There is no way in the world that Crane could have kept doing these rituals for such a long time under the radar unless it was right here in the manor.
So what are we looking for?
A secret room!
Yeah, okay, but there's not enough square footage unaccounted for there to be a secret chamber. So it would have to be under the building.
So we're looking for a passage that leads underground.
Secret room!
It's gotta be around here somewhere. We're running out of time.
Okay, he's kind of a douche.
We have to be getting close.
Whoa.
What? Put the candor back!
Nailed it!
Come on, hero, let's go.
That'll be 2 whiskey sours, please, man.
Scott, yeah. I need you to take this seriously. Stop messing around and stop talking in your weird little girl voice. It's a secret room. No, it's a secret room. I mean, you're doing a lot better than I thought, but still, you need to take this seriously.
Jazz. Look, I know I'm a jackass, okay? But I really do care about you. And when it comes to the people that I care about, I'm on board. I've got your back.
So prove it.
Oh my God.
They went inside, and what do?
We go in, make sure they're not dead.
What are you doing?
My good luck charm.
Wait, dead?
Yeah. So yeah, we go in.
After you.
Jessica.
Oh, nice creepy place you got here. Death is your thing.
Not so fast.
This one belongs to me.
The hell she does, Crane!
Hell? What do you know of hell? I'm about to bring hell to you.
Full stasis streams! Now! He's projected his abilities to Tuttle.
Come on, Crane. Why don't you come out and play with the big kids? Need a human host?
I don't need this bag of flesh.
Now you will witness the wrath of Amavoria.
shit. What did I tell you about poking the bear, Scott?
In life, we brought death. Through death, we brought fear. We bathed in blood and slaughtered without remorse. The dozens we've taken will pale in comparison to the thousands we will claim now. We shall cast a shroud of death over this city that will terrify the world. And you will never forget the name of Horse War 3!
Switch to proton stream!
Too late. No.
Proton streams aren't effective enough. He's becoming resistant. It seems like he's drawing the PKE in this area.
What are we gonna do? We could cross the...
No!
But we could totally...
No!
Dude, let's cross the...
No, do not even finish that sentence, Scott.
Rocky!
Alex!
Oh, yeah!
Get over here, boy!
Hey, guys. How did you get here?
There is a door.
Makes sense.
Yeah. We follow the PKE surge.
It's gonna take a miracle to take this bastard down.
Entities at this level usually have some sort of a catalyst. It's usually a physical object, something that anchors them to this reality.
If we could exploit that, then maybe we have a chance.
I got it, but you're not gonna like it.
Hey, dead guy!
No! No!
Your turn!
Why did you give me a beat?
So 5 seconds ago!
Scott just do something intelligent?
Yeah, I think so.
Damn it! This isn't working at all. We need something to balance the scales. Tip them in our favor. We need justice.
John Lasky, this is the man who took Marion from you. The time for justice is now!
Oswald Crane. You, your time of reckoning is at hand. I'm going to see you burn in hell!
Suck it, Crane!
That was so Sam L. Jackson!
Right?
Woo-hoo-hoo! Yeah!
Yeah! Isn't it?
What happened? Oh. Gavin, it was Tuttle. Tuttle, he was...
What happened?
No worries, Alfred. We bill in installments.
Ow!
Scott! I told you to prove it to me, and you did. You really have my back, don't you?
Yes, I do, Dr. Griffin.
Come here, jackass.
That was
that was cool.
Doctor Rookie?
No. Still Jinx. The boys back in Manhattan gave me that as a name, and it's a good luck charm.
Well, we couldn't have done this without you.
Oh, I know. But I'm no PhD either. I don't know why you keep calling me a doctor. Blue collar. Anyway, Jazz, you ready to roll? We gotta let corporate an answer on these guys here. They're gonna be certified or not.
You can tell them that these boys are the real deal.
All right.
They're officially endorsed.
What? Alrighty, fellas. Not bad. Ready to roll out?
I think I'm just gonna stick around here a little bit longer. They need a lot of adult supervision.
Yeah. Lasky, what happened? Are you okay?
Captain Davidson, I'm fine. I'm really all right. But just please don't ask me to write the report on this one. Cool.
That's all you, Jesse. I wouldn't even know where to begin. By the way, I just got a call from the hospital. The coma victims are waking up.
That's great.
Well, bro, how do we top this?
Man, I don't know. Funnel cake and cartoons?
Oh, yes.
Thank you, Dr. Kozowski.
Remember, it's one more semester.
Shut up.
And this is his first time without a practice melon.
Oh, looks like they cantaloupe.
Dude, the Panther doesn't need practice.
I don't need practice, right?
I'm down for practice.
Nice.
In love with a Mexican girl.
Nighttime would find
me in roses. Hey, Jinx. What are we going all the way out here for, anyway?
Haven't you two noticed the massive increase in paranormal activity at all these megalithic Native American sites? Like, all over.
It's crazy. It's almost like all of America was built on sacred Native American burial grounds.
Anyways, forget about that for now. Take a note on that, Spaz.
Duly noted, boss. I will write a note. And next to that note, I will put an even smaller note that says, I don't know, we're screwed as a nation.
Well, we've been called out here in yet another one. Might be related to that phone call I got from Kazowski and Bixby up in Colorado last week.
Huh. Okay. The note has been made. What does that mean for the three amigos, then, if that's the case?
It means we're about to get extremely busy.
Hey, more pay is always good for me.
Just for a moment I stood there in silence, shocked by the foul evil deed I had done. Many thoughts raced through my mind as I stood there. I had but one chance, and that was to run. Out through the back door of roses I ran, out where the horses were tied. Back and away I did ride, just as fast as I could, from the West Texas town of El Paso, back to the Badlands of New Mexico. Back in El Paso, my life would be worthless. Everything's gone in life, nothing is left.
So, the three amigos back at it again. What are you supposed to do first?
PK sweep.
Jinx. You know, like Jinx, but never mind.
How about you take the boy and go on the left?
How about you take the boy and go on the left? Ha!
Can't be right.
Oh, that was dramatic. Mr. Jinx? I know my eyes don't work great at night, but like, you see them, right?
Keep your eye on that. I'm gonna go make a phone call.
Got it. Eyes on target, boss. It has to be, I calibrated this last week. But...
You've reached Scott Bixby's Love Palace of Pain! Scream my name!
Bixby, it's Jinx.
Jinx! My man! I know exactly why you're calling. You are ready to approve my pay raise during my evaluation, right?
Did Oswald Crane just recently visit you?
No.
Well, there's your answer.
Funny, Jinx. Got those jokes.
Remember that phone call that you and Gavin sent last week about one of your spectral informants saying that there was something on its way to El Paso with a grudge against us?
Sure. Actually, been working that specter over for weeks. That's solid intel right there, brother. Direct from the underworld.
Well, it's here. Now.
These are right, then.
In El Paso.
Jinx!
I'm gonna have to call you back.
Jenks, you gotta see these readings, man. It's at least a Nexus Guardian level threat here.
Ah, damn it, the Thunderbird? I think he's been chasing us for years.
He's found us and he's brought friends.
The Thunderbird?
Ted, why do I feel like you guys do this to me? We're supposed to be the three amigos, and you guys feel like the two amigos, and I'm not anybody's buttercup.
We're getting overtime for this, right?
Oh, we're double billing.
Grab the beer, no pack.
You forget to charge the pack one time. Wait, we're getting overtime for this? Hey, how does this overtime thing work? Is it like time and a half? Like what, you know what I mean? Is it more extra hours or like, guys, I need, please, wait up. Wait for me. Come on, guys.